special guests this week are Cal Smith, our Texas boy, Brian Collins, and the happiest girl in the whole USA, Miss Donna Fargo.
But you can't be a beacon if your light don't shine. How can you ask for truth when you do not truthfully live? How can you ask forgiveness when you don't forgive? I don't mean to bring you down or speak to you unkind, but you can't be a beacon if your light don't shine. You can't be a beacon if your light don't shine. Child to be honest and true when he can only judge what's right by what he sees in you. How can you offer vision yet walk around blind? No, you can't see a beacon if its light don't shine.
Now on the show, I want to welcome my Oklahoma friend, Cal Smith.
Thank you.
Cal, who has a new guitar strap, emblematic of a new hit record.
That's right.
Country Bumpkin.
Made with love and care. Don Mills made this strap for me.
How about your boat?
Yeah, I've got a boat named Country Bumpkin, too.
Well, since we've now set the scene, do you know the words to the song?
I hope so.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Cal Smith will sing Country Bumpkin.
Walked into the bar and parked his lanky frame up on a tall bar stool. And with a long, soft southern drawl said, I'll just have a glass of anything that's cool. A barroom girl with heart and knowing eyes slowly looked him up and down. And she thought, I wonder how on earth that country bumpkin found his way to town. And she said, hello, country bumpkin. How's the frost down on the pumpkin? I've seen some sights, but man, you're something. Where'd you come from, country bumpkin? It was just just a short year later, in a bed of joy-filled tears, yet death-like pain. Into this wondrous world of many wonders, one more wonder came. That same woman's face was wrapped up in a raptured look of love and tenderness, as she marveled at the soft and warm and cuddly boy child feeding at her breast. And she said, "Hello, country bumpkin, fresh as frost out on the pumpkin. I've seen some sights, but babe, you're something. And mama loves her country bumpkin." 40 years of hard work later, in a simple, quiet, and peaceful country place, the heavy hand of time had not erased the raptured wonder from the woman's face. She was lying on her deathbed, knowing fully well her race was nearly run. But she softly smiled and looked into the sad eyes of her husband and her son. And she said, "So long, country bumpkin, the frost is gone now from the pumpkin. I've seen some sights and life's been something. See you later, country bumpkin." Said, "So long, country bumpkin, the frost is gone now from the pumpkin. I've seen some sights and life's been something. See you later, country bumpkin." Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Now, I want to visit with my buddy, Donna Fargo, the school teacher. Singing, do they call you the singing school teacher?
Yes.
Is that a handle that you've been using for years?
Yeah, a couple of years.
What'd you teach?
I taught high school English in Southern California.
When the kids came to see you from your class and you were singing, they held up a sign.
It said, "Donna Fargo learned us English."
Donna, you know this young man over here to
yes.
our left?
Yes, I certainly do.
He is from Texas City, Texas, and one of the bright new voices in country music. Ladies and gentlemen, you tell him who it is.
Mr. Brian Collins.
Somewhere there should be a statue of a fool made of stone. An image of a man who let love slip through his hands, and then just let him stand there all alone. And there on his face a gold tear should be placed to honor the million tears he's cried. The hurt in his eyes would show, so that everyone would know, conceal is a broken heart inside. So build a statue and Lord, build it high. So
now, folks,
on Pop Goes the Country,
it's time for our concert section, and here to open our concert is our guest, Cal Smith.
The life that I'm seeking is not in this bar where I'm sitting, but it sure ain't at home where the one that I'm married to's knitting. Happiness may not be here drinking beer, feeling it go to my head, but it ain't back at home where she's putting in curlers and rollers and dressing for bed. What I'm looking for ain't the blonde in the corner who's winking, but it sure ain't my wife that's devoted her life to dumb thinking. Happiness surely still lives in this world, and somewhere it's waiting for me. And I know that it must be somewhere between lust and sitting home watching TV. Somewhere between Playboy magazine and next Tuesday night's PTA. Somewhere between a honky-tonk queen and what all the dog did today. If a wife and a lover could be one of the same, what a beautiful world this would be. And there would be us somewhere between lust and sitting home watching TV. My wife's a good cook, but a man can't exist on just bread. And what I'm hungry for is the one thing I ain't being fed. I haven't been shopping, but there's lots of bargains walking through town tempting me. And a body could rust on a diet of lust and sitting home watching TV. Somewhere between Playboy magazine and next Tuesday night's PTA. A honky-tonk queen and what all the dog did today. If a wife and a lover could be one of the same, what a beautiful world this would be. And there would be us somewhere between lust and sitting home watching TV.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right, Donna Fargo, who's next on our show?
Brian Collins is going to pick up the tempo with the Ramblin' Man.
You got it.
My daddy was
country approaches its 200th birthday, here's Donna Fargo with a beautiful tribute to the U.S. of A.
Traveled your highways today. Used a creek and a rainbow for romance, and a tree for chapel to pray. And I'm so proud to sing your praises and to live of the free. I'm just one of your children who loves you, your home sweet home to me.
United States of America, America.
I believe in the red, white, and blue, and I thank you for all you've done for me, and I'll do my best for you. Citizen of my country, I believe it is my duty to obey your laws, to try to be a worthy individual, a positive example, and a productive and responsible citizen, to be informed and concerned about our nation's affairs and to voice my beliefs constructively, to practice diligently an attitude of brotherly love and hold no hatred against anyone, and when one of my brothers makes a mistake, be he peasant or president, I will try to treat him as I would want to be treated, with compassion and understanding. And I will continue to be proud to pay taxes for the opportunity to live in the greatest nation in the world. A nation born out of faith in God and sustained only if that faith and the support of the American people remain strong.
Yeah.